So here we go again, people. About 40% of concepti with Klinefelter syndrome survive the fetal period. In general, the severity of somatic malformations in Klinefelter syndrome is proportional to the number of additional X chromosomes. Mental retardation and hypogonadism are more severe in patients with 49XXXXY than in those with 48XXXY. The mortality rate is not significantly higher than in healthy individuals. Now, then in healthy individuals, that's basically implying that Klinefelter syndrome are unhealthy. Excuse me while I cough, I'm going off screen. I'm alive. Yeah. So, you know, they're basically saying a hell of a lot of stuff of, you know, that healthy individuals are not Klinefelter syndrome people, which is absolutely ridiculous. But anyway. Klinefelter syndrome does not have any racial predilection. Well, of course it doesn't. The only racist people in the world are, you know, the biggest Egypt anyway, so forget about that. Sex. Because the syndrome is caused by an additional X chromosome on an XY background, this condition affects only males. Now, that's a very interesting way of putting it, because actually, most of the time when you speak of XXY on forum sites on the internet, they expect you to be male. And in fact, there are XXYs who are female. And so that's a good way of actually putting it. Because the syndrome is caused by an additional X chromosome on an XY background, this condition affects only males. The only problem I have with that is that XXY I do not consider to be in the middle, right here, of the sexes. And I do not agree that it's male just because we've got male genitalia. Klinefelter syndrome goes undiagnosed in most affected males. It's true. Among males with known Klinefelter syndrome, Klinefelter syndrome goes undiagnosed in most cases, yeah. Among males with known Klinefelter syndrome, many do not receive the diagnosis until they are adults. The most common indications for karyotyping are hypogonadism and infertility. And that's true. History. Infertility and gynecomastia are the two most common symptoms that lead to diagnosis. Other symptoms include fatigue, weakness, erectile dysfunction, osteoporosis, language impairment, academic difficulty, subnormal libido, poor self-esteem, and behavioral problems. Physical growth. Infants and children achieve normal height, weight, and head circumference. About 25% have clinodactyly. Height velocity increases by age 5 years, and adults with Klinefelter syndrome are usually taller than adults who do not have the syndrome. Affected individuals also have disproportionately long arms and legs. Now, I absolutely am not in that category at all. I do not have disproportionate long arms and legs. And I'm not considerably higher than any of my family members. Yeah. And then, what they're saying is, some individuals with Klinefelter variant 49XXXXY have short stature. Now, most males with the 47XXY karyotype have normal intelligence. Again, what is normal? Family background influences IQ score. Subnormal intelligence or mental retardation may be associated with the presence of a higher number of X chromosomes. About 70% of patients have minor developmental and learning disabilities. These may include academic difficulties, delayed speech and language acquisition, diminished short-term memory, decreased data retrieval skills, reading difficulties, dyslexia, and attention deficit disorder. I would hope that with me reading this, you'd realize that I'm XXY Klinefelter syndrome technically, and I don't think I have too many reading difficulties. Yes, I think everybody has reading difficulties if they're speaking for a long time on a certain subject. Patients may exhibit behavioral problems and psychological distress. This may be due to poor self-esteem and psychosocial development or a decreased ability to deal with stress. Psychiatric disorders involving anxiety, depression, neurosis and psychosis are more common in this group than in the general population. Well, I'll give you one real huge point, that most people that are brought into hospital or in fact clinics for mentally ill psychiatric patients who are showing signs of anxiety, depression, neurosis and psychosis are most commonly not, and this is from my head now, most commonly not diagnosed with XXY or Klinefelter syndrome when they're in this damn psychiatric ward. Now that's disgraceful, because in fact I think testosterone, all these triggers, depending on which way, whether you're this in the middle, whether you're this way male, whether you're this way female, you know. But I think that like a friend of mine, XXY friend of mine, I was told that he had neurosis or psychosis and blah blah blah, and in fact he didn't, he really didn't. He had problems dealing with you know, normal things that normal people have to live with, and he was sentenced to taking drugs that were not for him. Yeah, now he's on testosterone and much better. So just last little bit, dental. About 40% of patients have torodontism, which is characterized by enlargement of the molar teeth by an extension of the pulp. The incidence rate is about 1% in healthy XY individuals. Sexual characteristics, just quickly, the last point here. Patients may lack secondary... Patients may lack secondary sexual characteristics because of a decrease in androgen production. This results in sparse facial body or sexual hair, a high-pitched voice and fat distribution, as is observed in females. Now, for me, yeah, lack secondary sexual characteristics. Yes, I had sparse facial hair and body hair, except on my legs. I've had very hairy legs, and I had hairy scrotum and hairy arms. And they say sexual hair. Stupid word. High-pitched voice I did have for so long, yes. And fat distribution, as is observed in females, yes, I do have that too. I always say we've got rounded bellies most of the time, but we don't all have that, and that's what I'm trying to get here. The point is that we're not all the same. By late puberty, 30-50% of boys with Klinefelter syndrome present with gynecomastia, which is secondary to elevated estradiol levels and an increased estradiol to testosterone ratio. The risk of developing breast carcinoma is at least 20 times higher than in healthy individuals. Well, yeah, I did get a mastectomy, gynecomastia, and got my breast tissue taken out of both breast areas. Post-pubertal patients may have testicular dysgenesis, small firm testes size 10 milliliters. Infertility, azoospermia, or both may result from atrophy of the seminiferous tubules. Practically all individuals with a 47XXY karyotype are infertile. Patients with Klinefelter syndrome mosaicism, 46XY stroke 47XXY can be fertile. Patients may have an increased frequency of extragonadal germ cell tumors such as embryonal carcinoma, teratoma, and primary mediastinal germ cell tumor. I'm going to leave it at that now, folks. I'm glad you watched that. People have been asking more about what XXY is, so I try and clarify and clear up a few things with you to the best of my ability. Bye now, people. Study well.